Blackstone Audio presents Excitotoxins, The Taste That Kills. How monosodium glutamate, aspartame, NutraSweet, and similar substances can cause harm to the brain and nervous system, and their relationship to neurodegenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's, Lou Gehrig's disease, ALS, and others. By Russell L. Blaylock, MD. This book is read by Tom Weiner. I dedicate this book to my dad, C.D. Blaylock, who has always been an inspiration to me, an exemplar, and without whose guidance and encouragement I would never have gone as far as I have, and to my mother, who likewise always pushed me to excel and guided me through the rough seas of life. Disclaimer: the information presented in this book has been obtained from authentic and reliable sources. Although great care has been taken to ensure the accuracy of the information presented, the author and the publisher cannot assume responsibility for the validity of all the materials or the consequences for their use. Before starting any regimen of vitamins or supplements, you should consult with your physician. Foreword. There are some discoveries which come when the time is ripe, when science, understanding, and research come together to allow a new synthesis. For example, understanding aerodynamics would have had limited use indeed in the early 19th century, since other components necessary for flight were undeveloped. In this context, Dr. Blaylock's book is a remarkable achievement, and the timing is right. The research, scientific understanding, and observation of disease, coupled with the increased use of neurological excitotoxins in our food supply, have allowed Dr. Blaylock to create this cutting-edge synthesis. Also gratifying is that Dr. Blaylock is a highly qualified professional. He is a practicing board-certified neurosurgeon with a deep understanding of the structure and function of the brain and nervous system. He brings his credibility to this critical topic. When Dr. Blaylock writes of neurodegenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's, Lou Gehrig's, ALS, and others, his voice comes from one who has studied and treated these conditions and offers many years of experience. Thus, his is a voice which cannot be dismissed by those who seek financial gain from the use of excitotoxins and who show little or no concern for long-term damage to consumers. When Dr. Blaylock shows how excitotoxins such as monosodium glutamate, aspartic acid, aspartame, NutraSweet, and others can affect the developing brain, we can see how our children are at risk. Is there a relationship between these deleterious substances in our foods and the diminution in educational test scores? Perhaps all the educational approaches to such societal problems are, very simply, off base. Scientific research has many receptors in the nervous system which can be affected by excitotoxins. In some cases, the excitation can lead to death of the nerve cells. The research correlation between these effects and the neurodegenerative disease are truly alarming. This is not the first time that toxic substances have been allowed entry into the human system, despite forewarnings. As a physician practicing for well over 20 years, and with a special interest in toxicology, I have seen the effects of long-term lead and mercury exposure in children, resulting in neurological damage. We have witnessed the pollution of Great Lakes fish. I am frequently reminded of the trucks on beaches with innocent children following after the sprays, having been assured of the harmlessness. This was a widespread practice in the 1940s and 1950s to try to rid the beaches of insects. I have witnessed defective medical products, such as medical devices and silicone breast implants, creating serious medical problems, having been assured by those with financial ties to the industry that they were safe. I believe we are witnessing a very similar event in the case of the excitotoxins. Our watchdogs have become industry pussycats, and the research supposedly demonstrating safety is deeply flawed. What is even more disconcerting is that many researchers have demonstrated how these studies are flawed. Some educated people have advised caution, in that they have said, "We don't want to scare people, so tone it down." I ask them to read Dr. Blaylock's remarkable and detailed book to see if they can still urge this caution. To them I ask, is it prudent to keep your voice low and scare nobody when poisoning is occurring on a day-to-day basis? Certainly, if you know the airplane you are riding in is defective, it is the least prudent thing you can do not to bring it to attention. The future of many of our citizens can be affected in subtle yet deep ways, and there are some who can be affected seriously on a day-to-day basis. Many of these substances added to foods can rightfully be called poisons. What concerned parent would knowingly sprinkle poison?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.